January. So this year is my 14th year. And I joined as a freshman from college. My only job so far. When I joined in 2002, there was a club in OTP. And the first meeting I went was in 2002, July. And I am ever so grateful to my colleague, Suman Sarkar, who left Oracle, he runs his own company now. He said, he's from IIT Kharagpur, he said, if you really want to change your career, come to Toastmasters. Well, I thought, you know, he's just bluffing. But I respected him because he was my team lead as well as, you know, IIT graduate. So I said, hey, why not go try? 2002, July, OTP, ground floor, OC001, I go. There are 50 people in the room, including erstwhile director Ranjan Chak. How many of you have heard of Ranjan Chak? Some of you at least? No? Ranjan Chak was the Oracle director for a long, long time. Oracle started in 1994 in India. So Ranjan was coming. I was like, wow, director of Oracle India comes to the session and he listens to people. He's like, wow, this is something I want to go. But how do I start? I mean, one sentence, I would make three grammatical mistakes. One sentence, four grammatical mistakes every session. So it took a long time for me to start speaking, maybe 6 months to 8 months. Probably 2003, 2004, I got really serious about Toastmaster. But then I started my journey. I did the CC. I took a long time. Nowhere close to what Prashant did. I took a long time for my CC, maybe 6 years. Then I was very much focused on my AC, B, ACS. Sometime later, I switched into training. I became a certified trainer. I train a lot. You can go to my website sometime later, pramodavasara.com. Everything is there. I became a consulting speaker, trainer, and coach. Last year, I invested close to maybe 2-3 months for 7 certifications in coaching and human behavioral change. I'm really fascinated about human behavioral change. So I went to Marshall Goldsmith. I did his stakeholder-centered coaching program, which is a very, very expensive coaching assignment we get. I'm really happy that I tried whatever I learned there in my own life as well as my team's life. I have a team member sitting here, Rajesh, who's in my team. We love these things that I learned. I believe that we all can make a big difference to people wherever we are. I think we are trying to make us a diamond wherever we are, instead of finding in greener pastures. Wherever you are, you can make a big difference and make something big in your life. 2007 onwards, there was no activity in club. So my friend Rajiv Raghunath, the director of marketing that time, so we got together one day and said, why not we restart the club? So for 4 years, the club was inactive. 2007, we started the club again with 20 members in the room. Now, when I see here, I was talking to Madhumita this afternoon. She said 53 paid members, and I hope all of them are serious about growing and changing. Now, as I sat in the room and I was listening to people, I was just counting the heads here. And I can see in this room, including me, there are 23 people. Now, don't count. I have already counted. Don't waste your time. There are 23 people in the room, excluding me. And I'm curious to know, including the new guest, Soumya, why are you here? Asking Soumya, why are you here?
Basically, I love to interact with people and speak with different kinds of people and learn myself. And I feel all are there in Orators Club, or the people with confidence and the people with something we want to do, something we want to improve, with that kind of attitude.
Anyone else who has not spoken so far, but in the room? Meaning you are in the room, but you never came here and spoke. Anybody who has not delivered a prepared speech, except her. You have not. Why are you here?
I like presenting speeches. And
okay, wonderful answer. Now, is there anybody who has done P2, let's say less than P3 or P5? When was your last speech?
1 month.
So, when was your last speech?
2 weeks back.
When was your last speech?
July.
So, what happened from July to October?
Still prepared.
The reason I ask this question is, most people join Toastmaster, as I said in the graph, I think it is still true. 40% people quit in 3 months. 59 quit in 3 months beyond. Now, the reason is simple. There is no reason. There is no reason to continue. There is no motivation. I mean, if my employee, Rajesh, in this room, you clear CC next year, I'll give you 30% hike next September. Now, do you think he will not do it? Would you not? He will stop coming to office. He will go prepare 10 speeches tomorrow. He'll come and say, I am ready. Can I get the hike tomorrow itself? There's a nice story. So one billionaire has five sons, no daughters, only five sons, and he wants grandchildren. Now all these five sons are dating and they're not getting married. They're not serious about having children. One day the billionaire decides, anyway, he has only 3-4 years to live. Let me make a change in my family. He invites all of them to dinner and says, after dinner, he serves them wine and says, you have not taken my word seriously. None of you is interested to have a family. Let me announce today, it's up to you. You have five people in this room and you have your girlfriends or spouses along with you here. Whoever gives me the first grandchild gets $1 billion. You think about it, I'll come back. So he's saying this, he says, I'll go to the washroom and come back in a minute. So the gentleman goes, and when he comes back, nobody's on the dinner table. And you can guess why. This is called sense of urgency. Right? If you have a sense of urgency, you will do whatever it takes. No excuse will matter to you. So you will do it. So my suggestion to Toastmasters, especially members or non-members, is find a reason before the reason finds you. Now find a reason to change, to face uncomfortable situations, face discomfort facing people before the reason finds you. The second suggestion to office bearers is do not be the people changing person. Do not think that you can get into somebody's brain, motivate them and make them CC or ACB or ACS. Most office bearers, what they do is when they become office bearers, club officers, they think their job is to convert you into multiple religions, just like religious conversion. They are not interested. You call them and say, I want you to deliver a speech. They will never, because there is no reason to deliver. So if you make peace with the concept of personal decision, there is no motivation. It is good for you, good for the member. Otherwise, you're constantly forcing 3-4 calls, they'll cut your calls. They'll not even take your calls. And how do you know that I know all these things? Any guesses? I was on both sides. In 2004, I was on the receiving side. 2008, I was on the calling side. When you see your next speech, I will give you education. So do not hassle people. Do not trouble them. You know, see, people will do what they like to do. People are complicated, including me. So just respect whatever they do. Whatever little they contribute, respect that. Do not put a lot of hope on that. We have a club distinguished point coming. We have a DCP point coming. Go, 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 go. Don't push. It's not their decision. Let them choose what they want. Give them freedom to choose and grow. Okay, so I don't know. Some of you are wondering why is that I'm speaking for so long on this topic. The reason is I am moving to the US. I have taken international transfer. So next Wednesday is my last day in India. That's why I said I'll come today to talk to people. I don't see too many members. How many of you are official members of the club? Oh, that's a good number, actually. Good. I'm speaking to the right audience. I thought you were guessing. So if you're a member, I really want to congratulate that you've taken the right step. I have been a member for 13 years now. I never missed my membership renewal, including this year I spoke to and said I will transfer my membership. One change I have decided to do is I have decided to join a club in Oracle US. There is a club. There are two clubs in Oracle US. One is in 200 building, which is for the Server Technologies Group. The other one is in Oracle Plaza, which is run by sales team. And you can guess, I would go to the club run by sales team. That's where a lot of these youngsters will come and say, passionately speaking and trying to sell things. So I have made up my mind to join the clubs. That's why I said, renew my membership, I'll go join the club in Plaza building. If you have any questions on things, I'm willing to answer maybe a couple of minutes. Otherwise, there's nothing much to share. We can meet after the session for our personal. And some of my friends here in this room, they have come to several trainings I have conducted outside, several sessions that I did outside. There are some people in this room where I met their entire team, did one day programs like Ananda and other people. I've interacted with different people in different forums. It has been really exciting. As I said, don't think how it will help you. Toastmaster will always help you because this experience you get here, it can generalize in your brain. Now, how many of you have heard of this gentleman called Tony Robbins? Anthony Robbins, anybody? Motivational speaker, trainer, coach, etc. Now, Anthony does something called as fire walk. You have really hot burning coal on the ground and he makes you walk on the coal, hot coal. I know, I'll finish. Thanks. So he'll make you walk on the hot coal And you will think, why is he doing this? This is crazy, insane. Why is he making us walk on coal? And his answer is, when you walk on that hot coal, your brain registers a new belief that you can do something which is impossible. And the same belief can be generalized. To me, this is less risky actually. If you can walk on hot coal, I mean, this is not difficult actually. So if you come here and experience this fear, you know, you suffuse your consciousness with the fear. Yes, I accept. I accept the fact that it is uncomfortable. I have butterflies in my stomach and many more places, but I will stand and go through this experience. And this experience can be generalized in your brain. You go anywhere, it helps you. That was my reason to become a Toastmaster, not because that I wanted to become something else. I said, yeah, this is nice. I can network with people, meet some really accomplished people. See, imagine if Ranjan Chah, being the director of Oracle, having maybe 1,000 people under him at that time. If he was coming every Thursday, why shouldn't I? Was my motivation. That's why I always tell people, if you are having senior folks in the room, please invite them, because if they come, if they have the hunger to change and learn, it will inspire the people. Because leadership does not come from bottom to top. Leadership comes from top to bottom. So if the leader has humility to come and sit here, automatically he or she draws other people to the room, because if he is doing it, there is something in it. I will not go, but I want all the money to come better than speaking. That's what our mentality is. We want the world to change, but we don't want to change. That's why I like to think today, you know, be the change in this world. Because if you are leading by example, that's what his speech was all about. He can inspire people because he led by example. He didn't merely deliver a speech. He did something and he's asking you to challenge and do it. Any questions here? I got one story before I finish. It comes from really close to my heart. I'll tell you a story and then go back to my seat. Do you have any questions for me?
Apart from passion, how you manage time and all these 14 years?
His answer. Excellent question. I think his answer is fine. If you have priority for something, you can do anything. It's about priority. Everyone has time. It's about priority.
You kept on delivering speeches and you felt that you were improving in your speeches. What is the other form of improvement you saw being a part of it?
Any other benefits of those?
Other benefits, personally.
Okay, great question. I'm not doing it from last 7 months because my priority shifted. I'm moving to another country. I may not run the same consulting outside. By the way, HR has a policy. If you want to become a trainer, there is a policy. Go sit with them. In case you want to go become a professional speaker, there is a process. Legal and HR will help you clear. Once you clear that, have your own website, talk to people. But there are some rules to follow. Very simple rules. But if you're doing it for non-profit, nobody will ask you any questions. When it comes to profit, they will ask you a few questions. It's a great question. So the motivation for me was, who does not like to become independent? Right? So instead of only one way to make money, why not look at other ways? You feel more confident in your life than you have other ways of making money. Great question. Anyone else? Any other question? There are many avenues. I have seen at least 6-7 people in my Toastmaster journey who left their jobs, did something different because they thought life could be more beautiful. Primarily in the area of training, coaching, and helping people. At least I have 6-7 examples who have got high paid jobs, including MD or something, VPHR of a big construction company. So this person left and he now runs his own training consultancy. He says, I want to speak, I want to help people, I want to train people. So you might discover the other side of you, which is willing to help people and challenge them to become better. I mean, I usually get the assignments, people say, can you MC this program? Can you become the moderator for this program? I may not get money. The sheer joy of going there and being the expert in the speaking, that really pumps your ego sometimes. I may not get any money. I've gone to so many Rotary Club meetings, they invite me, come and do this. There's so many places. Many conventions, hotel, especially these hospital industry, they always need new speakers to excite and pump up the audience, so they invite you. If you keep money aside, there is a lot of exciting things in Toastmaster. If you keep thinking, where will my money come, it doesn't help. If you are willing to contribute for 3-4 years, you get so many opportunities every week to speak. You have no dearth of opportunities. Okay. Now, for people who are thinking Toastmaster, I always tell the story. I tell the story to my son once in a week. The story is about not giving up. There's this temple, a beautiful temple, somewhere in India. And one night, in the temple, there was a conversation, the argument between the deity, the idol, Krishna idol in the temple, and the stone slab below that deity. Are you getting the picture here? You have a deity here, small, beautiful, nice looking Krishna, and there is a stone slab below that. The stone slab is asking the deity, hey, look, we both are from the same source. We are both from the same big stone that they got from that forest into this building. How come every day people come and step on me? They don't even care about me, but they venerate you, they bow to you, they put offerings on you, flowers, turmeric powder. You're a celebrity. How come? We are from the same source. How are you different? This deity starts smiling. Look, there is only one difference. We both are from the same source. There's only one difference. When the stone cutter was cutting, you gave up. You yielded. You broke into pieces. Now, I did not give up. I was one piece until the statue came out of that stone. That is the only difference. Even in Toastmasters or anything else in life, all of us are from the same source. Some of us quit in between. But people who don't quit, they get what they want. And I hope in this room, whoever has joined this journey of Toastmasters, you don't end up at this stone slab. Everybody in this room can be a celebrity. If not celebrity, something that you like, passionate about, do speak, overcome your fear. The only distance between the stone slab and the deity is, what's the difference? Do something. Don't give up. Do something, come here, speak, continuously speak. And you will go to a place where we never imagined that you would ever come here. So this can be the greatest decision you made. Please continue being a member, not sitting there, but standing here. Can make a big difference to you. And when you lead by example, remember, everybody is leading by example. When you lead by example, you change your team, you change your family, you change your friends, because you're always leading by example. You're doing something that can inspire people. So she talked about my running passion. I'm so excited this month. I saw you at KTM running. I ran my 9th half marathon, which is 21 kilometers. My personal best, 1 hour 56 minutes. And I'm 36. I feel like I'm 29 after running. Really, I mean, I ran, I saw you the thing when I came back. You did half or full?
Half.
Yeah. So I did half marathon, which is 21 kilometers, by the way. A lot of people say 5K marathon, 10K marathon. So that marathon word is diluted. Marathon is 42 kilometers. Half marathon is 21 kilometers. Let me clarify that. So I finished 21 kilometers in 1 hour 56 minutes. My best performance. I am ever so excited. I'm really excited on November 8th. I'm running one event in the US, 21 kilometers on the Golden Gate Bridge, SF Gate half marathon. So I am really excited. I'll come back to India December 1st week for a week, December probably 7th to 12th. I'm here for a conference on the same floor. When you come next time, I'm sure I'll make a visit to the club on Thursday. I'll meet you all again. Continue the journey. Remember the words of wisdom for members. Don't give up. Continue. For officers, relax. Don't try to pay people. Whatever religion they are into, they have to pay them. So all the best. I took a little long time for what I was given. Sorry for that. It happens when you're here for 30 minutes. Thank you.